Problem number 6, solving radical equations. We have the square root of x minus 3 plus 4 equals 2. So we're going to isolate the radical by moving 4 to the other side. So subtracting 4 from both sides. We have the square root of x minus 3 is equal to negative 2. Then right here, you should realize that if the index is an even number, the root cannot be equal to a negative number. The solution would not work out, so you will get no solution. But if you don't realize that at this step, then you will have to continue. So let's continue with this problem and see what happens. So basically we would square both sides because the index and the power would cancel each other out, so we have x minus 3, and then on the right side we get a positive 4. Now solving for x, we would add 3 to both sides and we have x equals 7. So that's why it is important to check your solutions with these types of problems by plugging your answer back into the original problem. So 7 minus 3 plus 4 should be equal to 2. 7 minus 3 is the square root of 4 plus 4, and that is equal to 2. The square root of 4 is 2 plus 4 is equal to 2, and 2 plus 4 is 6, which is not equal to 2. So I realized at this step that I'm going to get no solution for this problem, but if you don't realize that if the index is an even index and on the other side you're supposed to get a negative solution, that would not work out, then you have to keep on going and make sure to plug in your final answer back into the original equation to see if you get a true statement. But in this case you have no solution as your final answer.